what day May 28th is?
Oh, how can I forget that day? 58 years it would have been our anniversary. No, that was Jean's birthday. Yeah. I'm sorry. May 15th was my anniversary.
Do you remember what you were doing August 30th,
1955? 1955? August 30th? Haven't got a clue.
My motto's always been, when it's right, why wait until the middle of a cold, dark night?
When everything's a little clearer in the light of day, and we know the night is always gonna be here anyway.
I got an offer for you. See these albums? Throw them out. Forget them, because Lots of Tunes Record Company has for you one giant super-saving record called Lots of Tunes. It features the greatest hits from 1903 to date on one long-playing 63-hour album. That's right, 6,432 of your favorite tunes. And here's just a few of them.
How you doing?
All right.
It's good to see
you.
Good.
Yeah.
Tell me, I've had my research team do a little checking up on you. We got some background information.
Yeah.
I'd like to ask you a few questions, if you don't mind.
Go right ahead.
Okay. Now, one thing we found out is that you were one of the original Minutemen.
That's right.
Well, tell me, how did you come by this title?
Well, that was a nickname my wife gave me.
Tell me, how do you support yourself?
Oh, any old chair or table would do.
Anything you just happen to come up against.
Whichever closes, that's right.
Hello, is anybody in there?
What you want? On in.
Thanks.
Hey, you got match?
No, I don't smoke.
You will after I set on
fire.
No,
please. I'm only here to conduct an interview.
Who you?
I'm Ken Weaver, television fame. You want it, you got it.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Me, Ugg.
Ugg? Ugg. That's your only name?
Yeah. Ugly.
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 Oh, how you doing, Mr. Ugly?
Yeah. You want a leg of Big Bird?
No, thank you. I ate before I came.
Yeah, it's good.
That looks good, yeah.
Hello, I'm Morris Schwarzenegger. And what you see here are two pictures of myself. Only thing, one of them is not myself. It is a clown. And we'll be back with this story, plus more, on 6 minutes, right after a word from our sponsor, for the breakfast that serves itself.
Well, it's good to see you have a sense of humor at your age. That's really great.
Yeah.
Well, tell me, speaking of your old age, which is utterly fantastic, to what do you attribute it?
Wine and women. That's right. The women would give me the exercise, and the wine would act like a preservative.
Oh, I don't buy that. I'm sorry. Not for 1 minute.
You're Noah?
That's right, I'm Noah.
Is this the famous ark that you're going to take two of each kind of animal on, and that you're going to take your family and escape the great flood?
Who told you?
No.
Did you tell him? Did you tell my building now? Did you send him down here to push me to build it? Who are you, the building inspector?
No, Noah.
I told you I'd have it done.
Noah, he didn't tell me. He really didn't. I read it in the Bible.
You did?
Yes.
Then I tell no one.
How about those songs, folks? Well, you can get these songs plus many, many more absolutely free for only $8.95. Act now and get the album cover with it. Send before midnight last night and you can get a large-sized can of your favorite odor. Country air, city smog. Just spray in the air and you can enjoy your favorite odor right in your own home. Here is how to order.
Hi, Gene. How you doing?
Hey, I got a great idea. Why don't we just take a few minutes and we'll go out and get us a couple sheep? How's that sound?
Yeah, we should have a few. Yeah.
All right, listen. I know this place where we can go. It's a nice barn. It's nicely lit. Soft lights. Go in there. Get us a sheep. We'll have a real good time. You'll enjoy it. I've been there several times. Really nice.
You are a lot of fun.
You are a lot of fun.
It was these film clips and the lure of the unknown which set the basis for the story you are about to see. It is the story of three brave young men who gave their time and effort and risked their lives in search of the man-ape. And I'm Herb Weaver, and this is The Conquest of a Legend.
Gene flew out a little bit earlier. We picked him up at Purdue in Indiana, and he tried to get a little bit of information about Bigfoot and see if he could get some encouragement from the officials there. Gene, could you tell us a little bit about your events there?
I'm cold.
You're cold. Gene, it's 70 degrees.
I'm cold.
It's going to get colder when we get up in the mountains.
Oh. Well, here we are in Minnesota now. We heard Bigfoot came by here to take a drink out of the Mississippi. Over yonder is Wisconsin. We'll stay on this side looking for him. Don't know where he went.
Signs of Bigfoot are everywhere. Searching through crevices, climbing rocks. Gene and Rich both risked their lives trying to find signs of Bigfoot all over.
Looking at is Yosemite Falls. It leads down into this wonderful stream here. The water, so rich and pure, you can taste the minerals. Everything is just everything just tastes so well out here. It's rich in iron, potassium, magnesium.
Tell me, Gene, did you begin to get discouraged when you already traveled 2,500 miles and still never made a contact?
No, not really. We didn't really expect to find them here. There were a few reports of his turds in the area, but nothing really encouraging.
Now that the trip is over, fellas, have you drawn any conclusions?
Well, I think we could safely say that Bigfoot does exist.
You think so? Thanks for being with us. And until next time, remember, legends are facts waiting to be discovered, and facts are the basis of truth. And again, this is Herb Weaver, and this was The Conquest of a Legend.
No!